snowy finale. Most of the stories that I tell start on the LHR. Today, however, is different. We start on a railway very different to the LHR.
British Rail is very different from the heritage railways we all know. They don't run steam anymore and don't see the sentimental value in doing so. One reasonably chilly morning, some diesel engines were conversing with each other.
I've always hated the snow. I feel like it's only here to make our lives harder.
D199 grumbled.
I couldn't agree more. That silly white stuff is always making it difficult for me to start up in the mornings.
I lighten up. You sound so grumpy.
And I have a reason to be. It's always so annoying when I have to pull one of my express trains in the snow. And of course, on my way back to Paddington, I have to pass that, heritage railway connection.
Oh, come on. Are you still banging on about those steam engines? Give it a rest. I used to hate those claptraps, but they don't run on main lines regularly anymore, so I don't care.
Going soft in the radiator then? Pity.
Oh, be quiet.
You be quiet!
Suddenly, a loud entity horn blasted.
Oh my god, why don't you both be quiet? God, I've heard less arguments with the three big engines!
For the love of God, stop blabbing about your Northwestern!
At least my railway has its stuffs in order!
What are you saying about British Rail?
Oh no, I didn't say anything about BR!
But you're insinuating it!
Alright, settle down. D199 here, express is ready, so get going.
Right, sir, will do.
D199 was right about one thing. The snow was very annoying for railways. His train had been delayed for about half an hour, and when the guard's whistle finally did blow, speed restrictions had been put in place, so there was no chance of him getting there on time.
Come on, come on! Ugh, I already know the Paddington shunter is going to give me an earful! Is going to freeze up.
And at this point, it might as well, said his driver.
They were just about to rocket through Brixton when D199 crashed into a snowdrift, blocking the line. I told them, I literally told them, clear the line for the express, but no one listens to the drivers.
D199's driver walked down the train to inform the guard and the passengers about what happened. However, D199 was stuck. His driver came back with bad news.
Well,
some bus is coming to collect the passengers, but you'll have to stay here the night. Sorry, old boy.
Oh, for God's sake!
Cold air was suddenly interrupted by a very loud King-class whistle. King was doing final checks at the stations to make sure no one had been left there. His express had been terminated here, as the main line past Chilson had been completely snowed in. Is everything all right up there? After King heard no response, he decided to take matters into his own hands and check for himself. Dearie me, what's happened here?
What does it look like?
Well, we can't leave you here on the main line. Oh, I know. Why don't you come and spend the night on the LHR? I know you don't much like steam engines, but, well, it's at least something.
No, I don't want to stay the night on your grimy heritage line.
Too bad. I'm bringing you anyways.
Off me.
King was soon hooked up to the consist with a very strong cable. King's wheels spun fiercely as he tried to grip the rails. However, he was slowly able to gain grip and pulled him out. They were now heading smoothly down the main line and puffing towards the sheds.
Everywhere you go, take a look at the fiber cane. It's glistening once again. Candy canes.
D199 was still trying to start his engine as he did not want to stay the night here.
Toys in every store.
Pog and Edwin had been unwillingly woken up and had to shunt away D199's coaches. It took a lot of hard work and willpower, but eventually King got D199 and his coaches to Aberdale Station safely. Edwin and Pog were very tired. Then the foreman walked up. I've just got a call from the controller.
What?
VR wants us to clean the line for a special goods train. They said, if we do it, they'll fund our new turntable.
Pug relayed the information to the engines, and they all got very excited.
Well, what are we waiting for? Hit us with snowplows already!
Soon, the engines had been put into two groups, mainline clearers and ALHR clearers. Gwen, Pug and Edwin would clear the ALHR mainline. Liam, King and Adam would clear British Rail mainline.
Oh, please.
Give it a rest.
Big engines are so lucky. They get the easy job.
Come on, this damn snow won't move.
We all just need to push a bit harder.
Yeah, if you want to get stuck.
Before Adam could even finish his sentence, Liam had gotten stuck in the drift.
It's so cold.
Oh, just great. Adam, we need more power. Pull as hard you can to get him out of the drift.
Wait. New plan. This might sound stupid, but we're gonna ram into Liam at full speed.
Adam, that might as well be the stupidest idea I've ever heard. We'll probably end up just derailing ourselves.
If it's an idea, let's just try it.
Well, fine. Sorry if this hurts, Liam. It wasn't my idea.
The two engines backed up. And then charged forwards at full speed. And to King's shock, it worked. The drift was completely clear. King's face was blank. Adam, never again will I doubt you.
Good call. Now, let's finish off this cleaning job.
Was so important about clearing the line?
Maybe for it not to be a hassle for BR's workmen. Though I'm not too sure.
Well, I'll be if it isn't the Flying Kipper.
It was nearly midnight by the time everyone had returned to the shed, and Pug thought they had missed Christmas.
Oh no, we didn't even get to light the Christmas tree! We've ruined Edwin's first Christmas Eve on the ALHR.
Oh, it's fine.
Hang on, Bao, it's only 11:30. We still have half an hour.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Soon, all the lights were set up. D199 was dumbfounded.
You do all this work on Christmas Eve and get sad if it doesn't happen?
Ah, well, we do it for the sentimental value. And the smaller engines. As the engines all handed out gifts, they watched in confusion as Edwin's driver pulled out a foldable table where model replicas of all the engines stood.
You did all of this for us?
Isn't it a bit much?
Your railway gave an old engine a second chance at life. When I was found, I was slowly rusting away. Once I was found, well, I expected to be scrapped. This is the least I can do.
Well, can I just say that your addition to our railway was a great idea, and we all hope you keep steaming for years to come.
Hear, hear.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Pug! Merry Christmas, everyone!
Merry Christmas!
And so, the engines of the ALHR enjoyed their Christmas celebrations. Despite not being what they expected, it was still something, and they were happy with that. A lot had happened on their railway this year. An old engine once thought lost, found again. A diesel trialed, but ultimately sent back. But through all of it, they stuck together. And maybe that's what Christmas is about. Sticking together, as friends, as family.
I just want to take a moment and say, like, you know, thank you all for watching. Thank you all for, you know, continuing to watch the series. And don't worry, it's not done. Stories of the LHR will return in season 2. There's massive plans. I have a bunch of new characters. But yeah, until then, have a great Christmas. Have a great new year. Happy holidays. And, you know, just stay well, I guess. Good night.